morning, children. Let's begin with the prayer. हे भगवान तुझे प्रणाम, हे भगवान तुझे प्रणाम, तेरे बच्चे हम हो सच्चे, तेरे बच्चे हम हो सच्चे, हे भगवान तुझे प्रणाम, हे भगवान तुझे प्रणाम, पढ़ लिखेंगे योग्य बनेंगे, नया सीखेंगे करके देखेंगे, काम करेंगे नहीं डरेंगे, नित्य बढ़ेंगे बढ़ चलेंगे, हे भगवान तुझे प्रणाम, हे भगवान तुझे प्रणाम, माँ की सुनेंगे दूध पिएंगे, पिता की सुनेंगे व्यायाम करेंगे, टीचर की सुनेंगे दंगा न करेंगे, जल्दी सोएंगे जल्दी उठेंगे, हे भगवान तुझे प्रणाम, हे भगवान तुझे प्रणाम, बड़े छोटों का ख्याल करेंगे, सबकी मदद ऐसे करेंगे, किसी से ना लड़ेंगे, भेदभाव ना करेंगे, हर रोज हम यही करेंगे, हे भगवान तुझे प्रणाम, हे भगवान तुझे प्रणाम, तेरे बच्चे हम हो सच्चे, तेरे बच्चे हम हो सच्चे, हे भगवान तुझे प्रणाम, हे भगवान तुझे प्रणाम। Now we'll begin with English. Come to page number 60. Page number 60. The chapter's name is A Place for Everything and Everything in Its Place. On Wednesday, we have already started with this chapter where we have already introduced two parts of this. So this is the refrigerator and this is the study table. Now we'll go to the third part, that is the dining table. Now in this picture, there are a few things which are not to be kept on the dining table. So what can that be? So that is one book. So you will circle a book, and that is a ball. Can we keep a ball or a toy on a dining table? No, we cannot. So what do we keep on dining table? We have our plates, we have our bowls, we have our vegetable water jug, vegetable bowl, curry bowl or dal bowl, some fruits, all that can be on the dining table. So similarly, I have one picture out here of a dining table. So you can see there are plates out here with food. Okay, then there is dal, there is salad. So all these things can be on a dining table. Okay, so we cannot have a toy or a book or anything on a dining table. So that is not possible. Okay, when we are eating food, we need to have our eating things. There can be a spoon, fork, knife, all that can come on a dining table. Can you see there are bowls and plates of different sizes? So that is all part of a dining table. Okay, so you will circle these two. After that, come to this fourth picture. Fourth picture is of a wardrobe or a cupboard. What is it? A wardrobe or a cupboard. Okay, now here, what are the things that cannot come, that we do not keep it on a in a wardrobe? So there is something out here, something with vegetables or something, so that you cannot keep. Okay, and these are the balls in the cupboard. We do not keep balls with the clothes. Okay, we have a toy cupboard as separate cupboard, so we do not keep toys inside the clothes cupboard or a wardrobe. Okay, so you will circle this too. Now here on this, we have a cupboard here. Okay, this is how it looks like. So we have clothes, and very neatly we have to keep our clothes in our wardrobe or cupboard. So the dresses are hanging on the hanger. Then there are clothes out here, nicely folded and kept. So these are all the things that can come in the wardrobe. Okay, after this, this is also one type of a wardrobe only.
where all the things are placed very nicely and very neatly. Okay, and can you see all these small containers? So that can have whatever small things that you keep in your wardrobe. Okay, so that's how the wardrobe will look like. So what is the first question? Which of the things in these pictures don't belong there, which we have already circled? So these are the things that do not belong. Okay, now third, say where you will put them. Describe each picture in one or two lines. Okay, so for example, here is a shirt. So you will write as a shirt in your red and blue line book. You will write shirt. So what is the spelling of shirt? S-H-I-R-T. Okay, you can write any one line or two lines on shirt. So you can write, for example, I have 5 shirts in my cupboard. Okay, or I like a blue color shirt, something like that. So anything you can write about a shirt. Now what else? Pair of scissors was kept in the refrigerator. So you will write here pair, P-A-I-R, pair of scissors, S-C-I-S-S-O-R-S. Look at the spelling of scissors properly. It's S-C-I-S-S-O-R-S, pair of scissors. Okay, so you have to write one line about scissors. You can write anything. Okay, you have a blue color scissor, or you have a big scissor, you have a small scissor, something like that you can write. And then in the second picture on the study table, we had a pair of socks. So you will write pair of socks. Again, you will write one or two lines on the same thing. Okay, then there was a basket of toys. So you will write basket, B-A-S-K-E-T, basket of toys, T-O-Y-S. Again, you will write two lines on this. Then on the dining table, we had a ball. Everybody knows many sentences about a ball. So you can write sentence of a ball. Okay, ball is B-A-L-L. Then after that, what else was there on the dining table? There was a book. So B-O-O-K, book. Okay, so that we can write two sentences on a book. Then in the cupboard, we had a plate of vegetables or fruits you can write. So you just can write vegetables, V-E-G-E-T-A-B-L-E-S, or fruits, F-R-U-I-T-S. Okay, so you will write two sentences on vegetables and fruits. And there was egg, or those white color look also like ball, but we have already mentioned about the ball, hence we will write eggs. Okay, so you can write two sentences on eggs. Okay, so that's what you need to do for English. Then here there is a game, but naturally we cannot play it so well. But what we can do is, teacher will make children play the game word string. Now there's a game called word string. First, the child will say the apples, will say apples in the fridge. Second child will add one more thing and will say apples. Then you can say oranges in the fridge. The same way, the next child will go on adding one more thing. Now what you will do is, you will take any one out of these four topics. You can take any one topic, okay? Any one topic you will take and make a video, okay? So what you will say in the video is, for example, you are talking about the refrigerator. So you will say, my refrigerator has apples. Then second sentence will be, my refrigerator has apples and banana. Third sentence can be, my refrigerator has apples, banana and milk. Fourth sentence can be, my refrigerator has apple, banana, milk and curd. Fifth sentence will be, my refrigerator has apple, banana, milk, curd and lemons. Okay, so 5 sentences you will say orally. Okay, only in a video you are going to say this.
Then it can be refrigerator, it can be study table, it can be dining table, it can be a wardrobe. Okay, in wardrobe also you can say, in my wardrobe I have five shirts and three pants. So on and so forth. You will continue and say five sentences and with five different things in any particular thing. Okay, so this is what you need to do for English. Now we'll do the worksheet. The worksheet set which I have given, okay, come to page number 5. Here the page number is written and that's page number 5. Complete the pattern. Before that, you will write your name and date. On top of it, you will write the school name. Okay, my Uddan School MPSP. Okay, so I want you to write this name on top and then you will write your name and date. Now what is this? We've already done this patterns, but I'm just giving you for revision. So it's complete the pattern. Look at the each pattern below and then use the on the right, the box on the right to complete the pattern. Now what is this? Heart, heart, circle, heart, heart. So what will come now? Circle. So you will draw one circle out here. Similarly, you have star, square, star, square, star, square, crescent, then circle, circle, crescent, circle, circle. So you will finish this part, then you will turn the page. Okay, finish this, take a picture and send it to me. Turn the page. On the back side of this sheet, on the back side of this sheet, you will write any five things from each alphabet. Okay, any five things from each alphabet you have to write. So the alphabets are B, D, G, and P, S, R. Okay, so it is B, D, G, P, S, R. You will write any five things, okay, from these alphabets. It has to begin with this alphabet. Okay, the first alphabet has to be this alphabet. Okay, so you will write five things, take a picture and send it to me. Now for maths, we are going to do number names from 51 to 100. Number names from 51 to 100. This you will write in your square line book. Write your date and name and take a picture and send. So you will write 51 and then you will write the spelling of 51. Okay, then next line you will write 52, so on and so forth, and last number will come as 100. So HUNDRED, 100. Okay, you can write 100 or you can even write 100. Okay, so you can write 100. So this you will finish in your number book, that's the square line book. Take a picture and send. Now we'll do EVS. Come to page number 82. For EVS, for this particular page, again we will take help from Kian. Okay, so we have going to do palms and fists and hand movements. Before doing this, I'll just read out this to y'all. So palms and fist, at the count of one, open your fingers wide and stretch them at the count of two. Close your fist tightly. Bring your palms in front of your body. At the count of one, turn your palms towards the left. Okay, what is basically written is, so for your palms, what are your palms? Yes, so this is your palms. Okay, now at the count of one, open your fingers. So your palms are down right now. Now at the count of one, open your fingers. One. Okay, now. And it has to be wide and stretched. So like this. Yes. At the count of two, close your fist tightly. So that is very tight fist. So this is a fist. When the hands are closed like this, it's called a fist. When the hand is open, this is called a palm. And when we close it, it's called a fist. Okay? So that's what is the movement. So I'll just do 1, 2, 1, 2. We'll do set of 5. 1, 2. Put it down. Again. 1, 2. Again. 1, 2. Again. 1, 2. And the last time. 1, 2. So this is how palms and fist movement we have to do. Now, at this for hand movements, at the count of 1, bend your left hand at the elbow and bring your fist towards your shoulder. Okay, similar exercise. At the count of 2, bring your left hand straight to the shoulder line. Repeat the same exercise with the right hand. At the count of 1, bring both the fists towards your shoulder by bending the hand at the elbow. At the count of 2, spread both the hands straight at the shoulder line. Spread your hands straight without bending them to the elbows. Move them upwards and downwards like wings of a bird. Okay. So, what we are going to do is, at the count of 1, your left hand, you will fold it at your elbow. So, this is your elbow and you will fold it at your elbow. Okay. And at the count of 2, you will open both your hands wide apart. Okay. Now, you'll put it down again for the right hand. So, at the count of 1, you will fold your elbow, your hand to your elbow.
Okay.
Yeah. So, start. 1, 2. Okay. So, this is what we are going to do. And then, third set in this will be one where we fold both your hands at the elbow and then make it straight. Okay. So, first we'll start with the left hand. 1, 2. Down. 1, 2. Down. 1, 2. So, this set has to be done 5 times. Okay. This set has to be done 5 times. We'll show you one more time. Come on. 1, 2. Down. 1, 2. Down. 1, 2. Okay. And then the final movement is where we are making the hand swing upwards and downwards like a wing, like the bird's wing, slowly. Okay. So this is the movement. So this, you are just going to take a video of EVS and send it to me. Thank you, Kian. Okay. Bye. Have a good day. Bye-bye.